Today I'm talking to the actors that are a little bit more advanced. So what if you have a scene and you have to cry or show some serious emotion? Hey, what's up everybody? Marlon Ladd here. All right, this is Filmmaking 101 again. What if you have a scene and you have to cry or show some serious emotion? What do you do? How do you do that? Nobody ever talks about that. Why? Well, it doesn't happen that often in film, and most of the time that you do see it, it happens with women, but you're starting to see it a lot more with men. It's okay for men to express their emotions. They usually just don't want to express it in that way. But there are a lot of things that happen in life with real life characters that require a man to show some emotion. So how do you do that? How do you cry on camera? This is kind of my method, and this applies not just to that type of emotion, but any kind of serious emotion. You want to be prepared, okay? And you want to be prepared before you walk on camera. So what that means is when you're off camera, even if you have to tell the director to give you a minute so that you can get kind of in the mood before you step on camera, that's what you do. The last film that I was working on called Tulsa 1921, it's about Black Wall Street. So myself and my co-actor, Brooks Pollard, we were doing some things just like that. And one of the things that he did was he was supposed to be running and run out on the road and confront me.
No, wait. Clarence, it's me. It's me, Ben.
What you doing here, Ben?
I'm here to help. I'm trying to help anybody I can.
And what did he do before he did that scene? He went over there and he ran in place until he was out of breath, like out of breath for real. Instead of like jumping in front of the camera going, no, he was. So that part was real. As much realism as you can pull from that, then the better off your performance is going to be. And, you know, like I said before, if you don't believe it, then your audience is not going to believe it. What do you do to bring out that serious emotion? And we're talking about crying. So usually that emotion goes with sadness. So what I would suggest you do is to take a moment, however long you need, and you think about something that really makes you sad. It's gonna be hard to go there, but you know, you have to channel that energy of something real that has happened in your life, unless you're somebody that can just cry at the drop of a hat. But something that happened to you in real life, you channel that energy and bring it out through your performance. I have something like that in my life. I'm the kind of person, like, I don't ever cry. I don't really show emotion like that. But I have to channel that energy. And you do that, you take that time before you get in front of the camera. Then you tell the director when you're ready. Or if it's a good director, he knows what you're doing. And you can be standing there in front of the camera and they're not rolling yet, and you're getting in that mood, okay? So that's how you do that. Yeah, you can use like an onion to make your eyes watery, or you know, you can put some eye drops in your eyes. That works too. I don't know if that will really bring out what you're looking for, but that's an option as well, especially if you need to do something quick. You know, here's an example of just kind of getting into that mood and letting that emotion take over. All right, so I didn't do any cuts. You can see kind of how fast or however slow that took to get into that mindset. And that emotion for me was real. Like, you didn't see any tears fall, but if I would have done that a little bit longer, then you would have seen a lot more. You can kind of tell by my somber attitude that that's real. So that's my advice on how to be emotional or how to cry for a performance in a movie.
But you have to come with me.
Not as long as my people die.
Don't forget to subscribe and turn your notifications on, okay? If you like these videos, definitely leave me a thumbs up.